Hi there, I'm Julianne. I'm a software engineer on the Colab team at Google, and I primarily work on Colab's AI features. Today we're talking about Colab and three AI-powered tools that you can start using right now to supercharge your development, whether you're a seasoned developer or just starting out as a student. And those features are Generate Code, Explain Error, and Gemini Chat. And now, to talk about that a little more, we have our fabulous UX researcher on the Colab team, Key Lee. Hey, Key, thanks so much for joining.
Hey, Julianne, thanks for having me.
So, Key, when you're doing your research, you must talk to a lot of our users. So how would it help someone who's just learning coding like a student?
Yeah, so Gemini in Colab is for everyone who works with code. For students, Gemini in Colab are like their personal tutor. For instance, you can still write Python code, but when you face error messages or when you get stuck, it can give you useful tips or, you know, nudge into the right directions.
I wish I had that when I was learning coding. That sounds really nice. So what about someone who is a more seasoned developer?
For seasoned developers, it's like a great assistant. You are still in control. You are the one who is writing the code, but it can help you write the code faster or debug things faster.
Nice, that sounds really helpful. Now that we've talked about some of the benefits of using Gemini in Colab, how about we talk about a couple of my favorite features? Okay, so how can I use Colab's AI features to help me accomplish a real programming exercise? So today, what if I want to create a database with midterm grades for some students? For that, I would use the generate feature. And the way you use it is to open up a new code cell and then click the generate link that's inside of the code cell. This opens up a prompt where I can input what I want the code to do. So I can type in English text, create a data frame that has midterm grades for 10 students. And all I have to do is press enter, and then Gemini goes and outputs the code for my prompt. And now that I have my data frame printed out, I can use another AI-powered feature called Recommended Plots. So all I do is click this button, and it'll show me helpful ways to visualize the data. And all I have to do is choose one, and it'll capture the code for me. Okay, now that I have a good starting point for my app, what if I want to go and add a new student's midterms grade to my database? The way I'm going to try to do it is like this. And you'll see when I run the code using the play button, I will hit an error. If anyone's ever learned to code before, you know that errors can be really demotivating and frustrating, but Gemini will actually pop up this awesome explain error button, and it'll explain why I hit this error. But not only explain, it'll actually give me corrected code that I can just copy and use to help get myself unstuck. So now that I have some code in my data frame, what if I want to learn about different ways to visualize that data? I can ask Gemini Chat, how can I create a bar chart using Matplotlib? And not only will it output the code for me to accomplish that task, it will also break it down into steps and tell me what each step is doing, so I can now apply that to my code. But another really cool thing about chat is that it's much more open-ended. I can basically ask it any question about coding, technology, or anything. Thinking back to myself as a teacher, what is a good quiz question to ask a Python student? And it will output this question, which is, what is the difference between a list and a tuple in Python? And then it will give me a series of answers here I can use for my rubric. So there you go. Now you have a quick primer into some of the awesome AI features that we have built right into Colab. And thanks again to Key for stopping by to chat with us. So now that you have a primer into these features, I can't wait to see all the awesome tools that you built with them. Bye.